In the nombre del Padre, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning. Today's Mass, we're going to remember Helen, Azif, and Vincent, James, DiFrancesco. We prepare for this Eucharist by recognizing our own sinfulness and asking the Lord to forgive us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my fault. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Pardon the offenses of your people, we pray, O Lord, and in your goodness set us free from the bonds of the sins we have committed in our weakness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. I hear the whisperings of many, terror on every side. Denounce, let us denounce him. All those who were my friends are on the watch for any misstep of mine. Perhaps he will be trapped. Then we can prevail and take our vengeance on him. But the Lord is with me like a mighty champion. My persecutors will stumble. They will not triumph. In their failure, they will be put to utter shame. Lasting, unforgettable confusion. Our Lord of hosts, you will test the just who probe mind and heart. Let me witness the vengeance you take on them. For to you I have entrusted my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has rescued the life of the poor from the power of the wicked. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm. In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
I love you, O Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my deliverer.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord.
My God, my rock of refuge, my shield, the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. Praise be the Lord, I exclaim, and I am safe from my enemies. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. The breakers of death surged round about me. The destroying floods overwhelmed me. The cords of the netherworld enmeshed me. The snares of death overtook me.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
In my distress, I called upon the Lord and cried out to my God. From his temple, he heard my voice. And my cry to him reached his ears.
In
In my distress, I call upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
Please stand for the proclamation of the Holy Gospel. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Jews picked up rocks to stone Jesus. Jesus answered them, I have shown you many good works from my Father. For which of these are you trying to stone me? Jews answered him, we are not stoning you for a good work, but for blasphemy. You, a man, are making yourself God. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law? I said, you are God. If it calls them gods to whom the word of God came, and scripture cannot be set aside. Can you say that the one whom the Father has consecrated and sent into the world blasphemes because I say, I am the Son of God? If I do not perform my Father's works, do not believe me. But if I perform them, even if you do not believe me, believe the works, so that you may realize and understand that the Father is in me, and I am in the Father. Then they tried again to arrest him, but he escaped from their power. He went back across the Jordan to the place where John first baptized, and there he remained. Many came to him and said, John performed no sign, but everything John said about this man was true. And many there began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First, there were Jews that were trying to stone Jesus. And Jesus answered them, why do you do this? I have done so many good things for you. And they continued arguing with him, saying, we want to stone you because you are blasphemed. The Gospel of John had just related how Jesus had opened the eyes of a man born blind. And just after this chapter, we will find also how Jesus, we will read how Jesus brought back to life Lazarus. These are two of the signs, two of the good works that Jesus was doing relating this gospel. But those who did not want to accept him were rejecting him because of what he was claiming. They would not open their mind. They would not accept his words. He was pronouncing that he was the Son of God. And was asking them to change their ways, to convert. They refused to do that. This is why they were trying to stone him. In the conclusion of the Gospel, we have Jesus going back to to the place where he had started his ministry, public ministry, where John had been baptized, where John had called him the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, and where he had met the first disciples. So Jesus is like coming to the conclusion of his public ministry before him, going back again to Jerusalem. And he is consoled by the fact that there were people that were believing in him, that were accepting him. This is how we conclude today's gospel. We have seen in the first reading how the prophet Jeremiah was also being persecuted. Even his friends were turning away from him because he was announcing that if they did not change their ways, starting from the king and all the others, if they did not change their ways, then Jerusalem would be destroyed. They did not want to accept that message. He persecuted him. He continued on, putting his complete trust in the Lord. We open our heart today to receive this message, seeing Jesus faithful to his task until the end in Jeremiah. And we ask the Lord to give us always that spirit of accepting what God wants from us with complete trust in him during these days of prayer, or the days that we are spending at home because we cannot go out following the directions also of our civil authorities. We pray, we can use the refrain that we repeated in the psalm this morning. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice. We know that the Lord is always listening to us in our difficulty. The attitude that we have these days also, the concern, sometimes fear of the danger of contagious disease. Continue to pray. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and he heard my voice.
We now turn to God and present our prayers and needs.
We remember in prayer those who do not know God, or whose God is too small. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember in prayer those who champion the rights of the poor, the needy, and the oppressed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember in prayer those who take refuge not in God, but in alcohol or drugs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember in prayer those of our community in need, the sick, the dying, the lonely, the unemployed, and those in any kind of trouble. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, as we offer you our prayers and needs, we ask you to take away all our fears. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, and will become for us the bread of life. fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the sacrifice of your hands to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O merciful God, that we may be worthy to serve ever fitly at your altars, and there to be saved by constant participation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for through the saving passion of your Son, the whole world has received the heart to confess the infinite power of your majesty, since by the wondrous powers of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed in the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Holy Lord. God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord,
and
the resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring care to the fullness of the charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Communion antiphon. Jesus bore our sins in his own body on the cross, so that the dead to sin we might live for righteousness. By his wounds we have been healed.
Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were always there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the unfailing protection of the sacrifice we have received never cease us, O Lord. May it always drive far from us all that would do us harm. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we pray, Hail Mary, the Blessed Mother, will protect us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now we're going to have a half hour of adoration in silence. We invite you to join us to take advantage of this moment to present to Jesus our concerns, our fears, all that we need. And most of all, to pray for our own families that are here or far away from here, so that the Lord will protect them. We close the half hour of adoration with a blessing. prepare ourselves now to receive the blessing. First, we pray the Canto Verde in English. Humbly, let us voice our homage for so great a sacrament that all former rites surrender to the Lord's New Testament. What the senses fail to fathom, let us grasp through faith's consent. It's on page 238. Glory, honor, and adoration, let us sing with one accord. Praised be God, Almighty Father. Praised be Christ, His Son, our Lord. Praised be God, the Holy Spirit. Triumph, Godhead, be adored. Amen. You have given them the bread from heaven, containing in itself all delight. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us in the peace of the kingdom where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed be God, blessed be His holy name, blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be His most sacred heart, blessed be His most precious blood, blessed be Jesus and the most holy sacrament of the altar, blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and His angels and His saints. Salutatus.